Cheers to energy. Yes, people, what is going on? How are we doing? Okay, so just pulled up outside the gym. Lads, I'm not gonna lie, I feel on top of the world today. I don't know if it's because I've got a day off work, the sun's shining, or the fact that I've got like 600 plus grams of carbs in me. No, I'm joking. No, but seriously, like, I feel good. I feel alive. You know, it's over a week now since the show. Obviously, the calories have gone up, and yeah, it's good to feel alive, I'm not gonna lie. Speaking of feeling alive, cheers to energy. So just at the gym now, got a pull day. I'll take you through that and then we'll go from there. Yeah, I started with an A4, and then I went and changed my life. I might take out the red tonight. Put your arms around me, baby. I just wanna fly, make it last before we die. And I know you wanna ride. What's on your mind? What's on your mind? And my 92 got doors like my Lambo. Spend my last paycheck on some ammo. We don't follow trends, rest in peace and ammo. Your new shit sucks, I feel like Anthony Von Santosan. I was broke last year, I can't go back there. Nicotine fiend, couldn't even buy a pet, yeah. She don't know my music, told her I ain't mad, yeah. Let her cut that coca on my plan, I'm black, yeah. Cut my fingers on my bands, on oh, yeah. Cut my vodka with some Xan, oh, yeah. Cut me my guava in advance, oh, yeah. Backstreet Diamonds, watch them dance, oh, yeah. Put your arms around me, baby. I just wanna fly, make it last before we die. And I know you wanna ride. What's on your mind? What's on your mind? She don't wanna spend a motto. She gets paid to be a model. I take the lead, they just follow. Face it, you don't know that I don't. Pull up, I got some for ya. Something in my trunk for ya. But I got a good lawyer. They always try to come for ya. I'ma pull up in that Bentley with them fucking windows tinted. Depending how I'm feeling, take a drop of the extended. Think I'm showing signs of slowing home and just forget it. I guess it's what happens when you fucking handle business, yeah. I started with an A4, right? And then I went and changed my life. I might take out the wreck tonight. Put your arms around me, baby. I just wanna fly, make it last before we die. And I know you wanna ride. What's on your mind? What's on your mind? I was broke last year, I can't go back there. I was broke last year, I can't go back there. Gasoline and I went and lit a match, yeah. Tried to take the swag, I know I'm for a fact, yeah. Pull up in that Bentley with them fucking windows tinted. How I'm feeling, take the drop of the extended. Think I'm showing signs of slowing home and just forget it. I guess it's what happens when you fucking handle Benny, yeah. I started with an A4. Okay, so that's gym done. Did a little bit of cardio at the end. Just nothing serious, just to keep it ticking. So I just did 20 minutes of cardio. But like I said, I feel good. Like, I feel so much more, what's the word? Alive. But it's obviously, you know, near enough 2 weeks from the show. Obviously the calories are up. I think they're all kicking in now. And I feel this week, I feel really good. But enough of me blabbing on about shit. I'm gonna go home now. I'll catch up with you guys later. Okay, people, we are back. I feel like
all my videos are literally like 95% in my car, but right now I can't help it because I'm just a busy guy. I'm productive. I like to do things. No, I'm joking, but I just wanted to give you like an insight to, you know, there might be people watching about to do the first show. Okay, so today I just wanted to do a quick video on my personal experience after the competition, so post show. Obviously this is what I've experienced myself. Everyone could be different and experience different things, but these couple of points are just what I've experienced and want to share with you, just so you know, people could be out there doing the first show soon or in the future, and I just want to share my experience after post show. Okay, so the first one is accepting it's over, as in, you know, you do all this prep for weeks and weeks, months and months, you know, you've got an end goal, you're leading up to it, and then come show day, you've done it, step off stage, and the day later you wake up and it's just like, wow, like, what do? This is it kind of thing, you know, someone literally just pulls the plug and say, you know, that's it, you can do what you want, which sounds dead good, you know, it sounds good, like, oh, freedom, can do what you want, eat what you want, but my experience, like, I've literally just really struggled to accept it's over, as in I'm still going to gym as if I'm still competing in a couple of weeks, not as in, you know, my calories have gone up, but I've got that mentality of just go to the gym every day, you know, I've even done a few cardio sessions just because I'm used to it, and like, it's hard to come out of that routine kind of thing, if that makes sense. So it's really, you know, one of them is accepting it's over. It's hard to come out of that routine. You know, it's not all over. Like, don't get me wrong, in the future, there's other shows, you know, you can go, I'm going to go on a bulk soon, blah, blah, blah. But like, just for the time being, it's hard to accept that it's over. It's getting better now. It's 2 weeks on. So I am gradually getting out of it. Next one is kind of accepting again. So letting go of the stage look, you know. So when I stepped, like me personally, when I stepped on stage, I was the lightest I've ever been. 167 pounds I was, you know, I was pretty lean. And leading up to the show, like the last few weeks, I've really noticed, like, you know, the striations around the midsection really coming out, and it felt great to look in the mirror and think, yes, it's actually, you know, all the training's working, the nutrition's working, I feel good, I look good. Well, I don't feel good, I feel like shit, but I look good. And like I say, after the show, you know, you start eating, you're not doing as much cardio. And getting stage lean, it's a really unhealthy kind of physique, you know, it's not, you can't maintain it, it's not sustainable. So the last two weeks I have seen a difference in my physique, obviously, because I've been eating more, I feel a lot more puffy, which I think describes it best. The striations are slightly there, but they are going, but it's just natural, you know, it's going to happen. And it's just hard to, you know, you look in the mirror and you doubt yourself and compare yourself to a week before the competition, how shredded you were, as you see pictures of yourself, like, oh man, you kind of got like guilt of eating, which eating brings me on to the next one, my last one. So nutrition, of avoiding bad food. So what I mean by that is, obviously through prep, you know, I've had loads of cravings. I crave pizza, I crave pasta, I craved takeaways, fast food, you name it, I craved everything. And then as soon as I stepped off stage, that was it, like all my appetite went. Me and my mates literally walked around Dublin, and I just said to him, listen, you choose where you want to eat, because I just don't feel like eating. But what I've really been struggling with nutrition is, strangely, not eating, you know, your bad foods or your cheat meals, you know, your takeaways. Best way to describe it, I've been really paranoid of eating them type of food, you know, your takeaways, your naughty foods, basically. So, you know, for example, I think I was in Asda or something anyway last week doing the shop, and went down the pastry aisle, and all the cakes in front of me, and I literally took 10 minutes, like literally took 10 minutes to put them cakes in my trolley because I was that paranoid of, oh, if I eat them, I'm going to get fat, blah, blah, blah. It sounds really sad, but it's just literally what I've been experiencing. And another one, when I came home, I had Krispy Kreme donuts waiting for me. 12 donuts. I ate two and had to take the others, give the others away because I couldn't mentally accept to eat them, if that makes sense. You know, it was actually hard. It sounds so mad. But like I said, like, no one's told me about the post show, you know, what to do kind of thing. It's all new to me. You know, people might be watching this who've experienced the same thing. People might have experienced different things, but like I said, those three things is what I've been experiencing. It's 2 weeks on now, or getting on 2 weeks. I am getting better, as in, you know, I'm accepting it's over. You can treat yourself, you know, have a cheat day here, treat day there. And yeah, I'm just enjoying being normal kind of thing, if that makes sense. So if there is people here watching this, you know, competing this year, next year for the first time, if I was to give you advice, I would literally just say, you know, obviously you're going to be excited to compete. You know, I was, put everything into it. But I'd just say, don't get obsessed, you know. But bodybuilding, you know, competition, it's a very, very selfish sport, if that makes sense. And I notice how it affects the people around you kind of thing, you know, your relationship, your friends, your social, you know, going out with your mates kind of thing. Just be excited, but just don't get obsessed with it. Second one, just prepare yourself to, you know, let go of the stage look. You know, it's not maintainable. It's not healthy in a way. You do look sick, but it's gonna go. You know, you're gonna start eating normal and the weight will come on. So just accept that. You know, just mentally prepare yourself that you're going to change. And I'd say personally, after the show, just take a couple of days off or even a week. I took a couple of days off and I just listened to my body, really. I think I took 2 days off. Didn't weigh any, didn't like track any food or anything. And then I just felt like I needed to go to the gym, you know, went to the gym, feel fine. So yeah, just take time off, just listen to your body, and then just slowly get back into it, you know. Don't go straight into the deep end, you know. You put yourself through all that training prior to the show, after the show, get your rest in, and then just start up slowly again, you know. Increase your calories, not too much, and same with your training, just don't do too much, and then don't overdo it, and sure you'll be fine. Okay, so that's it, guys. That's pretty much the video. I just wanted to tell you guys about the post experiences I've had after the show. And I'm sure there's people watching it who've experienced this. If you've not competed and thinking about it, just bear in mind those five things I told you at the end. Anyway, so hope you enjoyed it. Hope you took some away. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. I'd appreciate that. And I will see your asses in the next one. Couldn't turn off the button. There we go. Peace.